Welcome back down to the basement. This is the Ibanez SR375 BBS bass. It is a super lightweight, fast, slim five-string bass from Ibanez. Let's go straight up to the headstock end and take a look at that. Here we go. Three and two aside keys. Little lightweight ones there. I'm going to flip the bass over, as I always do, for a quick look at the back of the neck. There we go. There we go. So there's your five keys. It's a maple and rosewood laminate, I believe. Tilt back headstock, so no string tree on this one, which is useful for tuning. Go down the back of the neck, here we go. We've got a 5-bolt connection to the body, which is also maple. Gonna have a nice bright sound and this lovely translucent finish. So this is a blackberry burst finish, hence the BBS in the model name. Active electronics, active preamp, so there's a battery compartment there. Just a simple little clip-off plastic lid there. Hopefully it won't break too soon. These little lids can sometimes be a bit delicate. Control panel lid, like so. And then as we flip the bass back over again, like so. Ultra skinny neck. We've got a 16 mil spacing on here, about 16.5 millimeters, which I really like. Normal 4-string basses I actually struggle with a little bit because I've played 5, 6, 7-string basses for a lot of years now, featuring a much closer spacing. So this feels a lot more comfortable to me. And there's nothing wrong with having a closer string spacing. Maybe a little adjustment to your playing technique and then you soon get comfortable with it. So don't be put off by that. Lovely fret finish on these. Considering this is a sub £500 bass, the fret job is fantastic, super great. So close string spacing all the way up the body. Onto a cast bridge here, quick release slots in the actual bridge itself. So string changes are going to be a breeze on this, like so. So moving around from the bridge, we've got the jack socket. Now I like this a lot. There's something very cool about the angled socket here, because if you've got a strap connected to your bass, your lead can go around like this, round underneath the strap, and the strap locks it in place, and there's nothing hanging, getting in the way. You can't stand on the lead and yank it out. So this is fantastic. I'm really pleased to see this available on the lower budget Ibanez basses, as well as the premium and prestige models. Okay, moving around, controls are nice and dead simple. Master volume control here. We have a pickup pan here, and then bass, middle, and treble. This is the active EQ I was talking about. This system is Ibanez's EQB 3D system. Just a bass, mid, and treble cut and boost. So hence the battery in the back. This is strapped to humbucking pickups. And as usual, what I'll do is we'll just go through the settings so you can hear those. We'll start with the front pickup. For reference, I am slightly boosting the bass and treble, leaving the mid flat. So round we go. This is just the front pickup. I'll do a little bit of finger playing and then a little bit of slap too. Okay, so here we go. Thank you. You can hear that bright tone coming through with the slap. I left that note a little bit so you could hear tons of sustain, nice new strings on here, tons of clarity as well, and the finger style as well. A nice rounded tone with body just for the front pickup. Right, let's zoom on back to the back pickup, and we're expecting that classic bite and middle drive, if you want to call it that. Same again, so finger style followed by a little bit of slap technique. As I said, he's got that nice kind of like bite from the back pickup. It'd be really, really cool for soloing as well. Let's have a quick listen to that. Tasty. I like the clarity. I was just digging in with my nails there, and you can get a nice little bite to the note, but it still sounds really rounded without too much sub information there to make it sound too messy if you're playing in a band context. So that leaves us with just the middle section setting to listen to. Let's do that. So fingerstyle first. Nice, loads of zing, but a nice balanced sound between the two pickups. It's got a lovely modern rasp to it. I think if we just pulled back the treble a little bit, we'd have a nice kind of thud to it as well. And I'm not really having to mess around with the EQ that much to get a variation of sound. So here's just a little bit of winding off of that top end. We're expecting something a bit more mellow. So there you have it. You can hear with the treble just pulled back a little bit, the bass has got a nice vintage vibe to it, nice and softer, ideal for other styles of music. I think the bass has got a really good modern sound to it, and I'd be happy to use it both in a professional situation or even suggesting it as a beginner or a spare bass for a gigging musician. I love the finish. It looks fantastic. The bass looks great quality. It's nice and lightweight, and the bright sound is going to reward you for years to come. So rounding up, this is the Ibanez SR375 in this lovely finish. And I'll put some more information in the written review, and then look forward to having you along for the next review in the magazine. Thanks ever so much for watching, and I'll catch you soon.